Oh, it's starting like right now. I just entered IRC like just when the go went on, so I guess we'll see how much delay Twitch have right now. Oh, like 15 seconds. Bonnaroo audio, okay, let's go.
Okay.
Okay, see, he says that too.
Oh, Fabien. On va essayer.
You have the choice. Either you hear French or English, I believe. I don't know where Moose is from. I guess America. I made the trailer and I don't even remember what flag I put against Moose's name. Yeah, he's from America, right? Okay. I swear I heard him talking German on his stream. So, I don't know what to expect from this race, really. Like, it can go either way. Obviously, Bonnaroo is favorite here. Bonnaroo has done some really strong run recently. But Moose is also very consistent, so it's going to be really interesting to see what happened. Moose just beat... I was about to say Mango. Moose just beat Marcos around just before, so that's pretty strong, but let me get the bracket. I think Bonnaroo beat CMA, right? So that's not a small feat either. Yeah, no, wait, Flo beat CMA. Okay, so Bonnaroo beat Alisa in round 2, Shaun in round 3, Flo in round 4, and Flo beat CMA in round 3, so that's pretty good.
Thanks, Moose.
And Moose beat Radiox, Jethro, and Marco, so that's pretty good as well. I'd say it's even more impressive than Bonnaroo. Molotov still haven't done his race, damn it. Yeah, I guess CMA wasn't totally ready. But still, CMA is strong enough that he can get good time even when he's not ready, I think. And Marco is like always really good. So there is a delay on the stream, obviously. They are tight right now. I don't know if it's Bonnaroo dropping frames or just Twitch being dumb. I don't know if Molotov is even going to get DQ'd. I don't know how that works. According to the rules, I think he should get DQ'd, but I don't know if he actually tried to race or not. Like, if he did try to race with Optimus, then I don't think he should get DQ'd. But I don't know. So yeah, Bonnaroo is doing escape. If this race is going to be as close as I think it's going to be, Bonnaroo, Bonnaroo child section is very important. You need to take as much time as you can. Moose already messed up going back into the crawl space. Input mistake. So Bonnaroo gets the west. Moose is failing a bit the bridge clip. And Bonnaroo get west escape first try. That's pretty good. That's what I was talking about. Bonnaroo really needs as much time as he can in the child section.
Slow but fast way. Hey Manu.
Yeah, Brad, I think so as well, but I think he was sick at some point, so he asked Aperture for a delay. But I guess it's been a while now. But yeah, it's true that Molotov isn't really active anymore. Alright, Moose is out as well. Well, I think Molotov entered the tournament because I called him out. Well, probably not because of me, but I told him he should enter the tournament and play and show that he's the best. He did enter, but so far I didn't show he's the best, so all we can do is wait, I guess, for Aperture to do something. I said that before, but it's a difficult decision, because if you do put Molotov in the loser's bracket, that's pretty much a guaranteed loss for the for his opponent, if he does decide to race, of course.
Yo, Zed.
Another solution is to DQ him completely and give a free win to someone in the loser's bracket, but I'm not sure if that's fair. Yeah, that's a huge problem, I agree. I guess I will tweet to Aperture, ask him. Actually, I can do that right now. Alright, so Bonnaroo is not getting the rupee, we'll have to get the backup rupee in market. That's okay. It is just like half a second time loss. 1 second and a half.
Ouais, c'est la demi-finale pour celui qui gagne.
Alright, so I got news from Aperture about the Molotov race. So, what is up is Molotov was sick, so he asked for a delay. And then Optimus Prime was in vacation, so he asked for a delay as well. So basically their deadline was extended for like, I don't know how much time, but like, it was extended twice basically. Alright, so far, good bottom of the well for Bonnaroo. Putting out the sword with the quick draw on the vine, I like it. That's the hard spot. Kind of good, but hard to practice. Because Dead End can mess you up really easily. That's a nice manipulation. You don't want to get too close to the end, otherwise you might get caught during your jump slash or something. And you don't want to have Dead End running into the wall, because if he does, he's going to get pushed by the wall, and it's really hard to predict how Deadan is going to get pushed. So you, it's very likely that you miss your jump slash and fail to hit Deadan. Alright, Vine Clip, down. See what's happening here? Deadan got pushed by the chest, and that's the same thing as the wall. That's going to push Deadan in a weird way, and you have to move very carefully, Link, so you can do the jump slash and keep a good spacing. But you have to do it fast, and doing movement carefully and fast is pretty hard. Yeah, keep in mind also there is a like 4 seconds differences between the two stream in favor of Bonnaroo. So like Bonnaroo is 4 seconds less ahead than you see in the stream. Alright, Moose did fail the slash on the Sculptiva. That's going to cost him a lot of time. Alright, he did get the event clip, so I guess he's fine. Both players are on VC. Only difference is the shield route. It's expected for Bonnaroo to be faster. The question is, can he be fast enough? Yeah, I'm using a moves timer. Don't worry. Shieldless route saves around 35 seconds, maybe a bit more, over getting the DQ shield. So Bonnaroo need to be like, yeah, a good 30 seconds ahead. Well, it really doesn't matter how much he's ahead, but if you're going to take risk doing a route that is hard like this one, you want to get as much time save as you can. Yeah, so far not much happening. Moose did a few mistakes, but nothing too big. And Bonnaroo is playing really well. He did a few mistakes too, but not much. Alright, Geralt's time. Geralt times, according to Frozen Knight. Or someone else, I don't remember. Alright, so far pretty good. I don't know what he's going to do for the last one. Oh, he's going for it. Nice. Good stuff. Oh, I guess 07.
Oh my god.
Bonnaroo failing to talk to Zelda, hardest trick in the game. But a 14.07 is pretty strong time. Oh, Moose with the swag super swim. I like that. Old school strat. Yeah, Moose is like 1 minute and 30 seconds behind already. He's not getting good RNG with Guard either. So you can see the difference already. Moose could have went for the frame perfect side up to the right like Bonnaroo, but he chose to wait and just play it safe. I guess that's smart for a race, but when you're behind already, well, I guess he doesn't know he's behind. Yeah, almost 2 minutes behind. Alright, I'm going to use this cutscene to go get some coffee. Or I guess, no, I'm going to wait Master Sword cutscene as Bonnaroo is almost done. Yes, Ixor got no one Warpworld record by 1 second. Like 2 weeks ago, I think. Something like that. It was recently. Oh, okay. Bonnaroo messed his angle, but quickly fixed it. Good thing he didn't pull the tube before. Oh my god, that could have been a really bad thing to happen to Bonnaroo, but good backup, really strong backup. Suboptimal backwalk angle, but I guess that's fine. Alright, dot skip. I was not complaining, just some stuff I noticed. It might not be suboptimal, I just think it's not the best for me. But it was still like very well done, so. Alright, buffered dot skip, that was nice. Easy cutscene skip for Moose.
Is it sub 19? Don't think so.
So Moose is doing rolls, but he messed up the first one. So I guess that was even in terms of movement mistakes.
Ok, bon, c'est pas mal pour l'instant. Pour une race.
Yeah, I'm waiting for Moose to get his dot skip.
Il en est où là, Moose? S'il y en a qui regarde.
skipping the backflip. I like that too. Alright, Buffer did not skip first try. Clean run. I'm going to tell you guys exactly how much time there is between the two. Moose did get some time back with Lullaby Cut and Skip. He used a faster setup and Bunnaroo messed up his setup, so... Yeah, still 1 minute and like 37 seconds between the two. It's a gap, but it's not a small gap. I mean a big gap. Moose can definitely bring this back really fast. So okay, I will be right back. Enjoy Master Sword cutscene.
Ok Flo, merci.
Okay, Goofy's hot. Bunnaroo on his way to Kakariko. Good movement so far. Bunnaroo is using Marcus Mushman in Kakariko. According to Adarax, it is faster to just roll through Kakariko because there is just so many turns you have to make. You can never backwalk for a long enough period of time to make it worth, and I think I do agree with that. But regardless, Bunnaroo with Dompe, I'm guessing 47. Oh, what does the Lotus do? TE backwork, what's that? Oh, you mean curving the backwork maybe? Yeah, I guess I thought about curving the backwork, but it's pretty hard to do there, I think. But it could be a good strat. Oh, okay, Z backwork, alright. Oh no! Okay. Little buffering, my worst enemy. Come on! Okay, this time I think it's Bonnaroo's fault because Moose stream is running fine. We are not losing anything, so I guess that's a 51. Oh, come on. Twitch. Bonnaroo. Whatever. Moose will get 45.
Because I get so angles.
Avec leur consentement, Gurdil. Merci, à toi aussi. Alright, that's better. And now the stream are like tied according to the timer, so. Okay, Bonnaroo with the shadow early. Oh, there is hard drop, but he doesn't get it. That's a smile time loss. But okay, good teamwork so far. Yes, really nice. 47 dumpy for Moose. Moose really isn't that far, like Shadow is going to be big, I think. Like, just say the Truth Pinner can make a comeback for Moose. Or make it worse, I guess we'll see. Bonnaroo's movement in Shadow are really good, so. Like, I think Bonnaroo is one of the best player in Shadow Temple, for this category at least. Okay, that's not a very good spawn. He has to wait. But it could be much worse. That's also a very easy spawn. So, no reason to screw up, and that's fine. Alright, Moose also getting Shadow early first try. Wait, first try, right? I was watching Bonnaroo, I was not paying attention. Yes, first try, okay. Yeah, a minute and a half, a bit less, I think. Bonnaroo is playing perfectly right now. His rolls are spaced beautifully. If that's a word. Alright, let's see. Okay, second try at least. Okay, second try. Okay, that's a better spawn for a dead end for Moose. He will save some time here. A bit harder spawn. Dead end might block the way to the chest. But I think he's fine. getting the fence clip. So that costs some time.
What the
f- Oh, twice? Alright. Okay, Moose with a three spinner. He needs second try as well, otherwise he's going to lose a lot of time. Okay, second try. So yeah, that's good for Moose. If he does a clean fence clip, he's going to save time. Let's see. Oh, Moose failed it as well. Fence clip confirmed hardest trick in the game. Okay, at least second try, that was a bit better. Oh, but he failed the wheel jump and he got the anti-gravity. That's bad. Another big time loss for Moose. Bonnaroo doing Shadow Boss escape. Alright, he got it this time perfectly for Moose. Second frame of the roll for Bonnaroo. He has to be really careful with the buffering right now. Alright, he gets it. Close. Hello, everyone. Bon appétit, Sapphire.
C'est vraiment un shadow moon, putain.
So I guess not a very strong shadow for Bonnaroo, after I said he was really good in Shadow Temple, but it could have been worse. At least he didn't fail any big trick, like failing the fence clip is, well, it costs some time, but it's not really a big deal. You don't lose bomb chews or anything. Moose fighting the Star Force like a boss and doing seven rolls. Alright, Bono killing Bongo. Easy. Alright, this race is amazing so far. Really close. Oh, and Moose is doing the bonk setup, I think. Yes. Oh, with the side up too? Oh, I've never seen that. That was super fast. I need to learn how to do this. Wow. Bonnaroo did the old setup with the 90 degree turn and the crouch stab of the door. Very small amount of buffering too from Moose. That was a really good boss escape actually. Not perfect, but really good. Yeah, I need to steal this side up for my runs. It looks sick and it looks really fast as well. The other option is to do an ESS turn and backwalk. But that takes time. Oh, okay, scary fight. Scary Bongo Bongo fight. No problem also. No DI. Alright, let's enjoy the beautiful rolls from Bonnaroo. Almost frame perfect rolls all the way, every time. Good backwalking girl, going straight to DC. Bad, please. Nice jump slash. Okay, I thought he was about to do the Bidog strat where you pull the two in midair even before backflipping, but that's a bit risky for a race especially. Nice backflip. Interesting he choose to go to the right of DC because then you have to make extra distance to get to the switch. It might not be very risky, but it is like a bit more risky than the other strat for sure. I've done it too, but I don't do it anymore because it does half a hurt of damage, and that's bad most of the time. Alright, that was a really strong split for Bonnaroo. Yes, Project, because you see, Bonnaroo did climb the wall onto the switch to the left. So if you go to the right first, then you have to make extra distance to get to that switch. It's not much really, but it is some extra distance you have to do. Please, Brad, that has nothing to do with it. This is a very bad example. But feel free to do it if you are good at it, that's good for you. It's Pydog's level. See, Moose go to the left here. And here, well, he can go straight to the door. It's a much better angle you have to get. But it doesn't really matter, it is just some movement details. Thank you. Alright, that's a good split so far from Moose as well. They are both doing the setup for that jump. It's a little slow, but it's very effective. What's up, Pit? I heard you are against Valiant Link in your next race. That might be very interesting. Oh, Moose doing this side up to get down. I like that. That's fast. And he can do it too since he has the health to do so. Both players showing good movement overall. Oh, please, Pythagoras. What a buster.
Déjà, j'ai pu skip les cœurs au début de DC, donc déjà ça c'est un.
Oh, it's missing.
Moose failing the stupid jump twice. Yeah, this jump never fails only once, but always twice or three times.
Hopefully, I don't get wrecked.
Quite a good lead for Bonnaroo still. Managing to keep a good pace. Very impressive. Alright, middle skip. Interesting. Alright. That went well. The angle was a tiny bit off, but it still worked. So losing a bit of time, but at least first try. Okay, good ground jump. Alright. Bonnaroo about to get into the spirit section of the run. That's where things get messy. Yeah, Bonnaroo's run is really good right now. I think that's a 122 pace. If he does a good ending, it might be like PB pace. Okay, so he does a super slide. No hacing. This angle is a bit off, I think. It might work. Oh, barely. Nice. Got the S. I mean the ESS. You don't see ESS much often anymore in OT. It's funny because everybody used to do ESS out of super slides, but nowadays everybody is trying to do S's. Alright, the bridge. Super slide as well. Oh, I think he missed it. Oh, I'm not sure if he actually did miss it. Okay, the backup strat, mega side up, gets it. Okay, doing super slide over S's is good because it's not that much slower and it is safer. But if you do miss it, You waste one more bomb than you would if you miss an S. So the risk reward is actually not that obvious. Choosing what strat to do in that section of the run is difficult. Because now Bonnaroo only has 10 bombs and he has to cut a slide. Or maybe even both slide. I'm not sure what he's going to do in Wasteland. Alright, Moose. Moose doing S's. Okay, he failed once. But he gets a second try, so even if you fail S once, that's still faster than the super slide. And that uses the same number of bombs. Okay, good gate skip. Hello. Yeah, at some point in the game, S's were like, people will not even think about doing S's. Like, that was pretty much TS only. Yeah, see, Bonnaroo cannot do any stupid slide or S's in Wasteland. He has to backwalk all the way. I'm not sure what kind of strat moves he's going to do, but I'm sure he will have enough bombs to do something in Wasteland. Well, if he wants to, that is. My guess is Moose is going to go for a mega side up right away on the bridge. Oh! No, he does for a super slide and miss it also. Interesting. For a long time, this super slide on the bridge used to be considered the hardest super slide in the game. Because the bridge is so awkward, the layout of the bridge, getting the super slide is actually not easy. So he does the mega setup backup but fails once. So he has even less bomb than Bonnaroo now. The Marco super slide, yeah. The first person to ever do the backwalk super slide was CMA. I remember watching a race between Molotov and CMA when they were both at the top level of this category, like one and two. Oh, Bonnaroo actually goes for the super slide here, interesting. And he misses as well, bad luck with the levers. And yeah, that race with Molotov and CMA, it was really close up to that point. And Molotov was watching CMA as he was waiting. He was a little bit behind and he saw CMA going for the backwalk super slide on the bridge and he freaked out. He was like, whoa, he's going for it, oh my god, or something like that. Like, it was amazing. Nowadays people hess up that bridge in runs. Or at least backwalk isn't considered that hard anymore. Okay, spirit over. I should probably watch this very closely. Exosol, please. That's the story. Well, I guess it was not so wrong, because both players did mess up that super slide in this race. Okay, what is the... Ooh, I'm not sure if that's going to work. Oh, it did, okay. Very close. Get the backflip. Oh, that looks good for Bonnaroo. That's a spirit over. But that's not over. Another super slide. Okay, he gets this one. And the jump slash. Making sure he doesn't fall off. Doing the setup to open this chest. Alright, so pretty good run for Bonnaroo so far. 50:03. Okay. No, Moose absolutely has to get it, otherwise it's going to be really hard for him to come back. Yeah, it's 1:23 pace, maybe better It depends really what kind of strat he does in the ending, and his RNG too. He has only, like, he doesn't have any bombs right now, he needs 3 drops. Oh, interesting. He's going for the chest. So that's going to cost him some time, but that's, I guess that's a smart move when you have no bombs left. Alright, Moose is struggling to get the Gwei. Gwei over can be a big time loss. He has enough bombs to not do it, but I guess it's always good to save a bomb. Okay, that looks good. It might be a bit too far. Whoa, close. Okay, get his angles. Alright, and Bonnaroo is about to do the boss escape. So many things to watch. He gets his angle with the hookshot instead of ESS turn, that's interesting. Okay, he buffers the jump slash. Gets it. Looks like Smooth is about to get his spirit over as well. Crazy. Okay, he's on the seam. Just a super slide left. Bonnaroo is on fire, like he's doing everything perfectly right now. Perfect boss escape, oh my god. Okay, Moose does get the spirit over though. That's still close. But Bonnaroo definitely doing a great job at keeping his lead. And most of that leads come from the child section doing West Escape. I guess Moose failed a little as well, so that helped him, but still. Half of his lead come from his child section pretty much. Bonnaroo might be PB pace. It's hard to say because he doesn't use his split. But he's on a good pace for sure. Alright, Moose is going for the RNG. I think he has to. Okay, a bit of a slow Nabaru fight for Bonnaroo, but that should not matter. Yes, Valiant, he did get the chest. Alright, only 2 drops for Moose, but that's not a big deal. Fight farming twice, he's still faster than the bomb chest, and he gets 20 bombs still. So that's Moose saving time over Bonnaroo. Not much, so I guess it depends how they will use those bombs. If they go for health in Garen Tower and like fast trail skip. Oh, missing the hookshot. He has to reset the room.
Merci, Choco.
That cost a bit of time. Alright. Hopefully this Cultula doesn't miss. Okay. Oh my god, that's very unfortunate. That would not have happened if Moose was a little bit more to the left when you shot the wall. But still, that is very unfortunate. And still, again, oh my god, Moose is getting wrecked by this Cultura. I've never seen this. That's crazy. The first time it was kind of Moose's fault. Like, see, he always hookshot right next to the Cultura. He could take a step more to go a little more to the left, and if he would do that, he would then avoid pretty much every chance of getting wrecked by the Cultura. But still, that was very unfortunate. Okay. Okay, good Bosky skip for Moose. Yeah, I wasn't paying too much attention to Twin Rova's fight, but I think he got a double. That Skulltula might have cost a run to Moose, like maybe. He did, right? Did he miss a shot or something? Probably not. Oh, he missed a hit. Okay, doesn't matter. He missed a hit, but he got the frame perfect lock. So he was able to make Twin Rova stay on the ground. Okay, Moose is doing a little of a slower setup for this trick, Nabaru instant skip. But he gets it fine. He has only one heart. I'm not sure what's up with Bonnaroo's life. I mean health. But Moo's one is very low. He will have to get some heart in forest for sure. Yeah. Bonnaroo lost like a lot of time getting bombs in the puzzle room, but if he used those bombs wisely, he will save a bunch of time because he's going to be able to use faster strat. Like basically, instead of doing the mega side up super slide, you can do the staircase over. That saves like 5 seconds if you do it optimally. You can has up Gallant Tower, that's another 4 or 5 seconds. And even super sliding in Gallant Tower entrance, save another one. That's not much, but that makes up from all the time loss getting the chest in spirit, pretty much. I guess a good fight too for Moose. It's kind of hard to see if the first phase of Twin Rova is actually going fast sometimes, because it really depends on their movement. Okay, Bonnaroo with the super precise hookshot up the tree, that was nice. That was not a perfect hookshot, but it was still very fast on those vines. I feel people underestimate how hard it is to hookshot in this game. You can easily lose time just hookshotting things. Well, that Skulltula is pretty easy to shoot. I still didn't pay attention to his house. One heart and a quarter. That's fine, he can survive one Starforce hit. Oh, first bonk in this run, I think. I haven't seen anyone bonk before. So yeah, there is 3 minutes and like 15 seconds between those two. Oh, that was scary. Oh, that was very scary. He almost got gem slashed. Super scary. Oh my god. This fight. Yes, he's going for the heart right away. Not messing around.
So bad.
He almost died like 3 times. Yeah, I guess Moose did bonk at the Shadow Boss door, and they also both bonked to that tree before doing guards to set up the health for the Lullaby Kitten Skip, but that doesn't count. Alright, block skip. Alright, second try and buffer. Good enough. I think at that point it's going to take a big mistake for Bonnaroo to let Moose come back, because there is just too much of a gap.
What? Okay.
Yep, that's a failed damage boost. It was not close enough to the ledge, so the frame were messed up. Didn't get the boost correctly. That will work if you get the frame for sure. That's close enough. Oh, I think that's the frame, yes. He couldn't see, but he knew it was a frame. Frozen, let's not talk about that. I was being distracted. Good rolls. Again, really good movement by Bonnaroo. Very impressive. Few mistakes in this forest, but still. Good hit. Nice. Perfect Starforce. Whoa, that was scary again. My heart. Alright, Moose is also doing great Starforce. Oh, that is scary. All right. Could have been really bad for a Stomper if he died. That was close sometimes. All right, Lax gets in skip. Not gets in skip, Lax only.
Why didn't you guys in DC?
Oh.
Sorry. Why didn't you guys in DC? I really only do in Hundo and in MC, so. Since this is my main category, I tend to forget to have you guys in those categories.
Oh, is it Yobo? Pretty nice. That's how it's done. Bonnaroo takes note.
What is a little different because you like the eyes? Well, that's not true in OST. But in Bingo, you like the eyes after you do a jump.
Moose movements are also very good, I think. He does some slower strat here and there. But overall, he's not making mistakes with his movement. This run, it was very unfortunate in Spirit Temple. Otherwise, it could have been really close. And, just a few mistakes. Bonnaroo did do a few mistakes as well, but I guess Moose just a few more. Plus the time loss of getting DQ Shield in Child Section. You can see the difference of strats fighting Stalfos. Bonnaroo is doing. Is approaching Stalfos like Marco would do without targeting the Stalfos and just tilting his crouch stab to try to shield poke the Stalfos. Moose is targeting the Stalfos to make them attack so they lower their shield and then he can hit always. Targeting Stalfos to do so is a little bit slower, I think, but it's a lot more consistent and a lot easier too. Bad, please stop this. Shield poking. It's a very advanced OT strat, as you can guess. The way you do it is just, you have to know kind of the hitbox of the shield, and you have to angle your joystick while crouch stabbing. Well, I guess before doing the crouch stab, you want to angle your joystick. And you want to have a certain spacing between Link and the Stalfos. Like, just... basically, the Master Sword has a length, like a range, basically. And you want to have that range between the Stalfos and Link. So you can hit the Stalfos with the tip of the Master Sword. And you have to aim either to the far left of the shield or to the far right, and you have to hit down as well. If you do target the Stalfos and make him attack, all you have to do is aim up with your crouch stab. You don't have to aim left or right, or most of the time you don't have to. It's good to know both strat because sometimes you won't be able to target correctly if the Stalfos is too close to you or something. If the Stalfos is too close to you, he's going to shield poke you and you will take a heart of damage. The far left is easier because Link is left-handed. I've never think about that, but the Stalfos do hold their shield in their left hand. So, I guess yes. Interesting. Fighting Stalfos is super fun in this game. There is just a lot of different strats you can do. For example, for a long time people used to do SVS strat, where you make a Stalfos jump slash you, and you roll under him, and then turn around and hit him in the back. So you get a hit, but more than that, hitting a Stalfos in the back makes him turn around and jump slash again. So you can basically do this infinitely. And it is very safe as long as you can roll. But it is a little slower, so most people don't do it anymore. It can still be good in some situation. Yes, rolling underneath the jump slash is a straight SVA popularist. I'm not sure if SVA actually did this first or anything, but he was doing that like a long time ago, and a lot of people saw this and did it too. There are a lot of strats in that game, little strat, that many people do, and actually that comes from SVA. You can look up SVA YouTube channel and you will find dozens of Ocarina of Time video about strats and movement everywhere. Alright, good staircase over for Bonnaroo. Really strong.
Déjà la système de chose.
Oh, almost a perfect fight.
On n'a pas le droit dans cette catégorie.
Well, Bonnaroo is still going strong. I think even if he does a big mistake, he will still be a lot ahead. Really good. Perfect fight. Nothing you can do.
Non, non, je l'ai pas fait parce que c'est interdit tout simplement. Si tu veux voir que
people don't do SVA strat much anymore because if a Stalfos do jump slash you, you can hit them during their jump slash instead of rolling. And if you move correctly a little forward after the crouch stab, the Stalfos is going to jump slash again. Oh, he died.
Oh my God, no.
He rolled too late, I think. Or I'm not sure what he did, but he was too close to the knuckle. I guess he was really far back when he did his first crouch stab. He can still die another time and he will still be ahead, maybe. Okay, this time. Yeah, he goes to the stair. That's an old strat. Wow, my voice is dead.
No.
Oh my God, Bonnaroo is giving a chance to Moose for the comeback. I've been talking too much. Okay, even though Moose has a lot of bombs, he chooses to go for the Mega Side Up Drill Skip. Interesting. He does equip Light Arrow though. Bonnaroo still have to do so. What's up, Vince? How are you? Thank you. Okay, good fight this time. Okay, saving this run.
Oh, mais je suis devenu une grosse merde sur cette moquette aussi. C'est un truc de malade. Il est où mon jeu? Probablement devant moi.
I have no idea, Brad. Well, I'm not really organizing anything, Vince. The tournament is being run by Apasher. Oh, Moose with the swag gainer up the chest. Yeah, this is winner quarter, by the way. First match in top 8. Moose did beat Marco the run before. So that's pretty big for Bonnaroo if he wins. He's going to be in a really good spot. Moose going for the S. He has to. Oh, and he gets it. Nice. Okay, the gap is closing. Oh my god. If he brings this back, I swear. He's still a lot behind. But half collapse skip can cost sometimes. Bonnaroo definitely have to do a really clean skip. Well, I guess first there is the Ganondorf right. That can also go pretty wrong sometimes. Even if he misses a cycle, that might be enough for Moose to come back. Oh my god! Alright. He was too late on the slash, a few frames too late. That's crazy. Bonnaroo was ahead since Forest Escape. He was ahead since Kirkery's World. But it's Ganondorf time now, and Moose. Let's see what he does. He doesn't miss. Oh, but he missed ISG though. He keeps trying for it. He goes for the frame perfect rush tab. Oh my god, he gets it. Amazing. That was insane. After missing ISG so many times, calming yourself down to do the curse tabbing with perfect timing is pretty hard to do. That was sick. Oh, you think he has no pressure? I think the pressure must be pretty high right now for both players. Okay, Bonnaroo, he gets it this time. And he gets ISG, fast fight. Alright. This is not over yet. Half collapse skip will determine the run. Unless something bad happens at Ganon. Let's see. Two side ups? Interesting. Oh, he gets the side up. The mega side up. Two more frames. One more frame. Struggles in the post buffering. Okay, he gets it.
Yeah, he did.
Alright, really good half collapse skip for
Moose. Or it might have been like
Stealth's fight
he
now.
He still had bombs, but he couldn't unequip choose or hook shot.
Okay. That was a good reaction on the crouch type because he was about to lose two health of damage to that jump slash. Okay, good Stalfos. Oh my god.
So I think while he was in DC,
that could have been pretty bad for him.
He couldn't change anything on three buttons, and then after DC, he only had two buttons.
Okay, well, Bunroo is playing fine as well, but this is Moose game right now.
Alright, should I try to head
again? I guess. See, Bunroo is not targeting the Stalfos, he is just trying to shield the poke the Stalfos, but he missed a lot. And if you do miss a lot against two Stalfos, you can get kind of like in a sandwich, you know? So, like, by the time you eat the first Stalfos, the other one is going to come behind you, and that can be really risky. You can die. But I guess he did well. Moose, the French Slayer. Yeah, actually, he is so far.
That would be like the ultimate two strat. Get near as well as like plus three.
Bunroo missed the kiss. That say it's all. I guess super slide can be a thing as well. But he gets the super slide just fine. Well, even with that many bombs, even if you fail the super slide, it's not a big deal. Unless you do a super slide too close to the loading zone, then you will actually get a grand jump. And that can be terrible. Actually, Greg knows about this. I remember Greg doing a super slide too close to the loading zone, and he didn't know he had a grand jump and he died, I think. But he can tell you that better than me.
Oh, yeah, that's true. It was only one
Molotov. No, Molotov basically had a delay because he was sick. And then Optimus Prime was on vacation, so they got another delay. But yeah, they are going to race. It's all under control. Bunroo gets the super slide, but Moose looks really comfortable right now. I don't see I don't see Moose dying to Ganon right now. Or losing that much time. He's just going to play it safe if he see that he's in a risky spot. See, he just rolls away and restarts the fight. Smart play, and that's it. Congratulations, Moose. Pretty strong race. Considering he got very unlucky in Spirit Temple, that's I guess that's a good race for him. He did lose like more than a minute to a Sculptula in Spirit Temple. So 1:27:15. Strong time for a race again.
Okay,
a bit slower than his previous race against Marco, but still very good for a race. He was behind since Forest Escape and he managed to come back all the way. I guess Bonnaroo choked a little. I'm not sure if he actually choked or he just did one mistake. Like Bonnaroo's run was really good on pace for 1:24. But then he did one mistake and that's it. Then he lost his focus and kept doing mistakes. That happens very often with Secret of Time. You do one mistake and it just adds up. And he almost died right here. I do hope Bonnaroo doesn't die. Okay, there we go. Vince, I don't think the time are reported, but you can check Zelda Speedrun. Not Zelda Speedrun, I mean Speedruns Live. And you go into Ocarina of Time, like you know, the page where every race are recorded. And you can see most of the race recently. You will see there is a bunch of No I Am the Wrong Warp race, so you can figure out what was tournament race or not. The best time so far in this tournament is 1:24:11 by Marco, I believe.